You use journals to make adjustments to your account data. Journals provide double-sided entry using debits and credits to ensure your balance sheet stays in balance. Total debits for each currency must equal total credits. You can save unbalanced journals, but you cannot submit them for approval or post them. You can use the data source dimension in data forms to view the amount prior to adjustment, the adjustment, and the adjusted total. Journal data is posted from journals to accounts as positive or negative values based on the account type. For example, for expense accounts, debits are posted as positive numbers and credits as negative numbers. To enter data for each entity in its local currency, use the journal input member of the data source dimension. If you need to enter data in a single currency for all entities in the journal, regardless of their local currencies, you can define additional data source members for journal input currencies. If you have adjustments that you need to reverse in a future period, you can select auto-reversing for the journal type. When you post an auto-reversing journal to a period, a journal with a reversing entry is automatically created for the reversal period you select. Users cannot post journals to a period until a system administrator has opened the period for journals. You use the Manage Periods page to open and close periods for journals. Once a period has been closed for journals, users can no longer post journals to it. You create journals in the Manage Journals page. Journals are created for a selected point of view that includes members for a scenario, years, period, view, and consolidation. In the View dimension, select Periodic to enter current period movement for journal line items, or select YTD Input to enter year-to-date or journal-to-date movement, and have the system calculate the periodic movement. For year-to-date journals, you enter the current year-to-date movement value. For journal-to-date journals, you enter the cumulative movement value across all years. When you post a YTD input journal, the current year-to-date or journal-to-date values are posted to the periodic member in the view dimension, and a reversal is posted to the following period. In this example, the January year-to-date value is 350, and a reversal of minus 350 was posted to February periodic. When the February journal is posted, the February year-to-date value of 500 aggregates with a reversal of minus 350 posted from January to give the periodic value of 150. A reversal of minus 500 is posted to March periodic. The YTD member in the view dimension is aggregated from the periodic values. Note that YTD input journals adopt a zero view for the YTD member for periods for which journals are not posted. In this example, the YTD reversal value of minus 500, posted to the March periodic member from the February journal, aggregates with the prior period periodic values, resulting in a March year-to-date value of zero. You can post journal adjustments to different levels in the consolidation dimension hierarchy. The consolidation input member you select determines the currency options available for the journal. If you post to the entity input member, data is posted to the entity currency member in the currency dimension. To input data for each entity in its local currency, select Journal Input for the data source member, or select a custom journal's data source member that is assigned entity currency. If journal input currencies have been defined, you can select an input currency in the data source dimension to enter data in a single currency for all entities. When the journal is posted, the data for each entity is reverse translated from the input currency member to the entity currency member. If you post to the translated currency input member, you select a single input currency from the data source dimension for all entities. No data is posted to entity currency. When consolidation or translation is run for the journal entities, the journal data is copied without translation to the parent currency member or to a reporting currency, if the input currency matches the parent or reporting currency. If you post to the parent input or contribution input member, you enter the line items in each entity's parent currency to the journal input data source member, and their values are posted to the parent currency member in the currency dimension. Journal numbers are assigned automatically. You can enter a label and description. You can assign journals to groups for filtering and reporting. Your business process can be configured to require an approval process. If approvals are required, journals must be approved by an authorized user before they can be posted. Notification emails are sent to approvers when a journal is submitted, and the journal displays in the approver's work list on the tasks page. Some journals are similar between periods. You can create journal templates with line items that you can reuse as needed. When you create a journal for a point of view, you can select a template to add the line items from the template. If you select recurring for the template type, a journal instance is created from the template automatically when you open a period. If you export a journal from your ERP system or from spreadsheets, you can use the import option to import them into Financial Consolidation and Close. To learn more, visit docs.oracle.com.